So just watch.
Sit here. Thank you. So today I'd like to ask you a few questions regarding your condition. Is that okay with you? So can you please tell me what brought you to the hospital today?
I'm having severe knee pain.
Oh, I'm really sorry to hear that. Can you please tell me a little bit more about your knee pain?
So I was fine till a few days back. Then I was having I was having fever with chills and then after that my knee just started hurting and I think it's swollen also and I'm not able to walk. It's really painful.
Oh, I'm really sorry to hear that. Can you please point the side? Is it only right side or left side?
No,
right knee or left knee?
So you can see it's swollen and like
it's only confined in left knee.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Does it move anywhere?
No, it's just in my knee.
Is there anything make the pain increase?
I can't walk, I'm limping. I can't wait there.
Okay. Is there anything make the pain decrease?
Well, if I lie down, I feel a bit relieved, but still, it's still, there's constant pain.
Is there any specific time in the day the pain increase or decrease?
Yeah, like if I'm working, I'm doing something, standing, and by evening, I just can't move my leg.
Okay. How badly affecting your day-to-day life?
I can't do anything. Nothing, no work at home, nothing. Can't take care of my child.
Sorry to hear that. So, can you please describe the pain for me? Is it colicky, cramping, or stabbing?
No, it's like a throbbing pain. I feel like there's something inside and, you know, something's like pulsating.
I understand. So, if you had to rate the pain for me from 0 to 10, 10 being the force, you can imagine.
Nine.
How do you rate it? 9 out of 10. So, do you get any trauma around the knee?
Well, I'm not sure if it's related to this, but so I went like trekking like a month ago and I fell down and I had some bruising and but then, you know, I never took any medical treatment for it and I don't know if it's related.
Have you noticed any changes of size or shape of your knee?
Yeah, I feel it's a bit more swollen now.
Do you experience giving away of your knee while walking?
No.
Is there any locking of your knee while walking?
No, not exactly.
Any sound produced in your knee while walking?
No, I've not noticed.
Okay. You mentioned it's swelling. Is there any redness around the knee?
Well, I'm sorry, I have not noticed if there's any redness.
So how's your appetite been?
Appetite is normal.
Have you noticed any unintentional weight loss? So, do you have any diarrhea recently?
No.
Or any rash, painful red eyes?
No.
Any other joint or back pain?
No.
Have you experienced any stiffness around your knee?
No. I mean, I can't walk. I don't know, the bending is so painful. Maybe that's making it
still. Okay. I'd like to ask some few more questions. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Do you have any recent visit to GP or any surgery recently? Taking any medication?
No.
Okay. Are you allergic to any drug?
No.
That got some personal question also.
Yeah.
Do you smoke?
No.
Do you drink any alcohol?
No.
What is your occupation?
I'm a homemaker.
Is it live with you?
Yeah, my family and my I have a child.
There any other family member in your family has a similar problem?
No.
Okay. So. What do you think? What may be the cause?
I'm not sure if it's something related to, you know, the fall I happening, but it's really painful, and I just want some pain medication. I want to go home and take care of my child.
So what's your concern and expectation from us?
I just want my pain to be relieved, and I want to walk. I don't want to limp.
Understand. Do you have any other problem like chest pain, breathlessness, or
no.
generalized weakness?
No.
Okay. Thank you for your cooperation.
Okay, do you want to summarize?
Yes. My patient, 28 years old lady, presented with pain in the leg knee, which is swelling recently, and his stroke trauma recently, and the pain increased gradually, and the pain scale is 9 out of 10, and then no associated symptom with that. So yes, my differential diagnosis maybe the septic arthritis or maybe osteoarthritis.
Any history of fever?
Yeah, she had any history of fever.
How would you investigate this patient?
So for this patient, I'd like to do some routine investigation, that is full blood draw, urine electrolyte, LFT, CRP, as well as joint fluid aspiration and CS. I'd like to do some imaging tests for her, like X-ray, knee joint, epidectal view, and weight bearing. And also like to do an MRI of knee joint.
Right.
To check any meniscal tear or any other minor injury that maybe escape.
The joint aspiration,
yes.
What would be, what did you talk about?
Joint aspiration for culture sensitivity or maybe any other parts.
So can you tell me a little bit about the how septic arthritis may develop in an adult and the organisms that are typically implicated?
The typical organism is Staphylococcus aureus. It may be due to osteomyelitis, trauma after trauma, or maybe injury, or if the patient is immunocompromised sometimes.
Okay,
mechanism of septic arthritis.
Yes.
So mechanism of septic arthritis, the bacterial invasion, and then inflammatory reaction of the and exudation of fluid and other content.
Okay.
And
so
development of pus around the knee and
so on.
So
the bacterial invasion. Could you just talk about how the bacteria invade?
The bacteria invade through cellular matrix and due to inflammatory reaction, also neutrophil release some factor, chemotactic factor. That